Well, Lewis Clairvert. Well, he looks pretty normal to me. Well, okay, a bit of an honest with his shirt off, but hey, we all look good with our shirts off, right? All right, time to suit up. Luckily, I borrowed these off my four-year-old this morning. And by borrowed, I mean stole. Stretches, all right. Two can play at that game, Lewis. Y-M-C-A. All right, Tony, now look like you know what you're doing. All right, move the block back. Easy, easy, I can do that. And now stand up on the blue thing like a pro. Ooh, nice feet. Well, that's a bit of an unflattering angle, but hey, if it's good enough for Lord, it's good enough for Lyall, right? Show some sportsmanship, bit of a handshake. Oh, you cheeky devil. You're gonna stand there and look at me like a weird Terminator?
I've been waiting for you.
Thank you, Mark.
Well, hasta la vista, loser. Oh, you're instantly beating me. That seemed easy. Oh, I should have told you about this guy before I got in over my head. Gag there. Anyway, over to you, hype guy. Wellingtonian Lewis Clairvert is headed to Tokyo after qualifying in the 200 and 400 meter individual medleys. That's a mix of butterfly, backstroke, breaststroke, and freestyle. The 22-year-old broke both New Zealand and Oceanic records in the 400 meters this year, landing him at the number 3 spot globally. Meanwhile, over in lane 9, things are looking a little dire for Tony Lyall. Tony took swimming lessons as a child, and in fact, his mom was a swimming instructor. Well, he certainly has humiliated her here in the pool today. And Lewis is almost finished. Luckily, I plan better than I swim, and I prepared something earlier just in case Lewis finished faster than I did, which he obviously has.
So we've got a little bit of time to kill while the race progresses because someone's slowing us down. So we might as well ask some questions. Lewis, mate, how are you feeling about the Olympics?
Yeah, look, I'm excited. A little bit nervous about all the COVID restrictions and that sort of stuff, but honestly, just ready to race.
I hear a little rumour that, like, you are a realistic shot for a medal at these games coming up. Someone even told me that, like, the best chance is Daniel Loader. How does hearing stuff like that make you feel?
I guess it makes you a little bit excited. I guess the pressure comes with just sport in general. But, look, I'm just taking every day as it comes, and if I can get myself into the final on the 25th of July, then I think anyone in that final has a shot to medal. So, yeah, I guess there's a good opportunity there.
Did I beat him?
Oh. It was close.
Oh, man. Oh, that sucks so much. How long have you been finished for?
Oh, I don't know, a couple minutes maybe?
He looks dry.
Lewis, mate, cheers for that. How did I go out there?
Yeah, look, that was a good effort, I think.
Good effort, I will take that. And how are you feeling?
I'm alright, eh? Not too bad.
I mean, I should hope so. You are an Olympic level athlete and I am probably Commonwealth Games. What do you reckon? All the best for Tokyo, and I had a cool down, so I'll catch you in the showers.
Sweet, thank you.
Olympic trampolines are a little different from the kind you might find in your backyard. These bad boys are designed to give the most bounce possible, launching gymnasts up to 10 metres in the air. Maddie Davidson is New Zealand's first ever woman trampolinist to go to the Games, and at 22, she's the youngest in her event. But I'm not here to talk about Maddie. I'm here to beat her at her own game. So I thought I'd come in hot.
What's the hardest move in the trampolining textbook?
Oh, gosh, we've got lots. That's a hard question. My opinion, it would be something called a full front half, so you do a full twist in the first somersault, a front flip, and then another front flip with a half twist, so triple flip, three spins.
I'm having trouble even imagining it, let alone doing it.
Yeah.
Well, I was pretty dizzy just listening to that, so we started with the basics, and it turns out they're not that basic.
Okay.
That's it, and you can just watch down in the blue mat in front of you.
Sorry, I swore.
You're going to have your arms up by your ears, and you're going to try to hold them there for the bounces. Yeah, that's it.
That's outrageous.
That's it.
I don't know if it is it, quite frankly.
You're getting it, it's all right.
I was already pretty puffed out, so I thought I'd take a break and ask her some more hard-hitting questions.
Being able to do a backflip, that sort of thing, that must be the ultimate party trick, right, if you're out in an event just busting one of those out?
Yeah, it is a bit of a party trick until you get to a party with all gymnasts and then everyone's just trying to one-up each other. It's not really too special with the backflip.
Okay, well, I'll steer clear of parties that are full of gymnasts. I'll be humiliated. And I heard a little rumour that you did one at your high school ball.
Yeah, in my dress and my shoes. Yeah, it was good fun.
Weren't worried about the stiletto damage if you landed weird?
No, I suppose in the moment you just chucking a backflip round and hoping for the best in the end.
I couldn't avoid it any longer. It was time for me to chuck a front flip and hope for the best.
So you want to try have your arms up by your ears, okay, and then you want to push and tuck. Oh. As a good start, we can work on it. Chuck it in, yay! Oh. Give it like a 3 out of 10, but we're on the way up.
Oh no!
Way, it's definitely getting closer. Yay! Oh!
Oh, no.
I knew I could get there eventually, so I thought I'd take a break and let Maddie give me something to aim for. And then, with thoughts of Olympic glory fresh in my mind, I landed a singular front flip.
Yes. Hey!
He's done it! He's landed a front flip. Ooh.
What an absolute legend. Megan Signal is headed to Tokyo to compete in the weightlifting women's 76kg class. The 31-year-old has only been competing for about 8 years, and already she's got 7 New Zealand and 2 Oceania records under her weightlifting belt. When I turned up, it became immediately clear I wouldn't impress her with my strength, but I did give it a go with my knowledge of the sport.
So the snatch, correct me if I'm wrong, I did some internet research before I came, that's the one where you just whack it over your head in one go.
Yep, there's a bit more to it than whacking it, but
yes. Talk us through it. What is behind the snatch? How do you sort of do it?
So the snatch, yes, essentially is getting it from the ground overhead in one movement.
And the clean and jerk, can you talk us through that?
The clean and jerk comes from the ground, goes to the shoulders, you stand up, the clean, and then you reset, and then you jerk it up overhead.
So you do the snatch and the clean and jerk, that's one competition, you do both of those things?
Done, we're literally going to Tokyo to do 6 lifts.
Should we do some teaching on this one here?
We're actually going to start here.
Yeah, on the broomstick.
So we're going to jump, and then we're going to catch with the weight at the shoulders.
Okay, just do it?
Yeah, just do it. Nice, instead of doing this, we've got the hips to be back, elbows to be up.
Oh, yes.
And then stand it up.
Stand it up, put it over my head?
No, we're just going to do the clean
first. Oh, just stand up?
Yep.
You're right, I see. Yeah,
elbows underneath. We're going to dip the knees, and we're going to jump, but when we catch it, we're going to catch it overhead.
Yeah.
And then stand up.
Great.
After only a few practices, I advanced to an empty bar.
Yes. Felt good. Did it look good? Why are you laughing so much?
Practically identical. And then it was time for the real deal. Me and 26 whole kilos.
I'm imagining this is for the gold medal, by the way.
Right. Lockout.
Yes. That is a round of applause.
There's a gold medal right there.
But as it turned out, Megan was doing a bit more than I could safely accomplish.
This is a total of 65.
65 kilos, a little under my body weight. So this seems very heavy to me. How does this compare to what you'll be lifting at the Games?
Ideally, that will be 50% of what I lift at the Games.
50%. So this again?
Yes, that's the plan.
What's your PB? I'm going to have to put this down.
Personal best is 123.
123?
Yeah.
That is incredible.
She'd been so generous with her knowledge that I decided to leave her with a few words of advice of my own.
Be careful, please.
I will, thank you.
Be careful.
For the first time ever, surfing is an Olympic sport. And New Zealand is sending Raglan native 31-year-old Billy Stearmond. If you're a surfing grom or rookie, you might not have heard of Billy just yet. But you've probably heard of Kelly Slater, who's considered the best surfer of all time. Well, Billy beat him.
Yes, about 10 years ago now, I had Kelly Slater in a contest at Margaret River in Australia, and I drew him, just me and him in one head. It was quite big waves, and I was going up against 11 times world champion, and it was just me, little hobbit from New Zealand, little Kiwi, and no one kind of knew who I was, and I had no big expectations. I just wanted to go out and surf.
There it is, Billy Stearman from Raglan, New Zealand, takes down the 10 times world champion.
But that's definitely one of my top achievements so far.
But that's far from his only achievement. Billy's racked up not one, not two, not three, but eight, yes, eight national championships. Now for his greatest challenge yet, the Olympics. But first, his second greatest challenge yet, teaching me how to surf.
Firstly, we usually do a warm-up.
All right, let's
do it. Yep, all right. Well, normally I try to warm up my arms, and then the back. Rotate the back, a bit of a lunge, and then open up the chest.
Oh, God. You've gone advanced instantly. Yeah.
Are there any other competitors that we should keep an eye on who you think might be the sort of ones to beat?
I don't know. I mean, it's an awesome field. There's a couple world champs in there and some amazing competitors. But for me personally, I'm just kind of trying to focus on what I want to do and what I want to achieve. Obviously, a medal would be awesome, preferably gold.
Yeah.
But my goal is to medal at the Tokyo Games, and I do believe that I can do so.
All right, well, I'm going to take some of that confidence and challenge you to a best of three wave series to see how hard surfing is. Do you think you'll beat me?
I hope so. I'm pretty competitive, so let's bring it on.
All right, well, so am I, so let's rip into it.
Surf's up, dude, and Billy is off to a great start on wave number one. He's up and Tony's down, which takes us to wave two now. Billy, once again, looking good. He's in the green room. The only room Tony's seeing is the emergency room. On to wave three now. Billy again, looking fantastic. Tony, Mr. Average, falling off. Is he up? No, he's down. He is down. But he certainly looks happy about that 1 second of glory. Look at him. What a legend. Of all the tasks I've been asked to complete so far, this is the one I feel most confident about. I've swept a few legs in my time, and I'm coming into this well prepared. Andrea Anakin is New Zealand's first ever Olympic karateka, aka someone who does karate. That's mainly because this is the first time karate will be an Olympic sport. It's also because she's incredible. I don't have time to list all her achievements, but it's fair to say it's a massive list of first places, both here and overseas.
Can't help notice you're wearing a black belt.
Yes.
Even the non-versed in karate like me knows that means that you know your way around a karate ring.
I'd like to think so, yes.
And it also means you could probably kick me in the head, maybe? Could you be able to kick as high as my head?
I think so, but I'm not going to try.
That news was a relief. But the relief didn't last long. What I found out next was far worse than getting kicked in the head.
And let's talk about your event. Most people know karate from, the Karate Kid and that sort of thing.
Yes.
How does that translate to a competition context?
So I do kata. I'd like to call it the art form and martial arts of karate. If you can imagine kind of like a gymnastics floor routine, but it's set so you can't deviate from that because otherwise you get disqualified.
So it's sort of like a choreographed dance routine for fighting?
Yes, yeah.
A choreographed dance? Perfect. My confidence was waning, waxing off, if you will. Karate Kid reference. Anyway, back to the task at hand.
Okay, do you know the first rule of karate?
Is it don't talk about karate?
No. If somebody wants to fight you, you run away.
Yeah.
And then if you can't run away, that's when you have to defend yourself.
Okay.
Okay, so this way.
Your one's gonna look so much cooler than mine.
Yes, so from here, twist at the end. Yes, good. Okay, so punch and...
palm strike.
Open. Yes, correct. Open hand straight.
Oh, that doesn't feel good at all. I feel like a sort of dolphin.
After my flippers were nice and warmed up, I was ready to throw down. Me, just a normal guy attempting an Olympic level sport against a world champ black belt, all right?
Papurim.
Papurim!